What the tour operators term as middle market Magaluf is, in common with many other European resorts, getting busier every day. 10 years ago, this was a deserted beach with hardly a hotel in sight. Even 3 years ago, there were just 6 hotels here. And now this. And it's all because of the simple economic law of supply and demand. The holidaymakers demand, the Mallorcans attempt to supply. But in the race to create a resort in what at times looks like a builder's yard, are the suppliers keeping those who demand happy? Well, let's find out.
Well, I like it mainly because it has all that a holiday resort has to offer. If you like the Mediterranean, which we love very much, we like the sun, the sea, the sand. It also has the 3 Bs, booze, bed and breakfast.
It's quite different from what I thought. It's more commercialised than it has. We were told 3 years ago that it was a very nice, quiet place. I find it more commercialised.
We were here last year and we've come back again this year, so I think that just about says everything.
I think it's ideal, the beach particularly, for children.
The only thing I had against it here is the roads and the pavements. If they were just attended to a wee better, before they move on to another site, if they just clean up the rubbish they'd left, to sort the pavements and to make the roads a wee better and a wee safer.
Of course, the drinks are marvellously cheap, aren't they? We've got that to be thankful.
The hotels that we have at the moment here, they are fantastic. You know, the food's great. There's no complaints at all, but like I say, a couple of more years, I think we'll still see a great improvement as far as nightlife and that's concerned.
Oh, I think it's absolutely fantastic. Look, just look at it, it's great. Why could you get this lovely weather? And fancy meeting someone like you too. Couldn't do this at Blackpool.
When the family leave the beach, hopefully having had their money's worth from the hired sunbed and umbrella, which here costs 50 pence for half a day, it's back to the hotel. Magaluf boasts a range of hotels going from 2 stars to 5 stars. And in a travel world which has yet to reach international consistency, the star rating system here is a little difficult to define. In simple terms, it means that in 4- and 5-star hotels, the menu's more varied, you'll not have to fight a running battle with the more extreme quirks of Spanish plumbing, and you can find lifts that actually work. In 2- and 3-star hotels, guests sometimes prefer to bring their own pots of marmalade and sauce bottles to the meal table to add to a more rigid menu. This, the Antilles Hotel, has a 4-star rating. So, let's go inside and meet a 4-star family. Meet Mum, Mrs. Carol Hunt from Coventry, preparing for a night out. Who's going to look after the children while you're out, Mrs. Hunt?
There's an excellent babysitting service. One for the younger children where an English-speaking nanny will sit in the room with them. And there's also one for the older children where a nanny walks round and just pops in every 10 or 15 minutes.
Where are your children now?
They're next door in the playroom.
And Dad's in the games room, Mr. Ian Hunt. What are the facilities for entertainment like here, Mr. Hunt?
They're very good. We have this games room. There's water skiing, tennis, card room, and we have an excellent pianist too.
And where are you taking your wife tonight?
We're staying in the hotel. We're going to the nightclub here.
Right here at the wine shop. Champagne at rock bottom price, 19 pence a bottle. Don't tell Judith, but that's what I gave her. And if you fancy mixing some brandy with your champagne to make a champagne cocktail, brandy, 66 pence a litre. Up the road, there's a newsagent's shop where you can buy Monday's Mirror or Tuesday's Telegraph on the days they actually come out. For the ladies, there's a boutique selling trendy gear, just what you now realise you've always wanted. Well, you should have thought of it before you left home. It would have cost you less there. But you can save money by popping into the supermarket and buying yourself a picnic lunch, and then hire a car and get away to some remote beach or to the less crowded countryside. But take care as you go, for Spanish motoring laws are strict. The cost per day for a car with reliable insurance is dearer than at home. It's about £5, but the mileage is unlimited. So off you go for a reasonably cheap day out. On the other hand, you could stay at home for the day. Home from home, here at Ye Old Bull and Bush. Well, almost home from home, because here you pay just a little bit more for your pint. Thank you. 20 pence for English bitter.